Before we start, I just want to say this was made partly as a travel vlog that you might find interesting and as a keepsake of my holiday. So hopefully not all the jokes are lost to you and you enjoy it. Welcome to the Cornwall Adventure, a journey of allure, mystery and mischief. The Motley crew consists of Chris, Alex, and of course me, the host Liam. Join us on a quest to a part of the UK more inbred than my hometown Canvey Island, the Southwest. Let's begin with this dodgy intro that we filmed on the fly. Hope you like it.
Yeah, you can go.
So we're heating up the roads. We're going way out west down to Cornwall. We're going to go and hit up the West Country. We're going to get a few Cornish pasties in, get some coastal views in. We're going down to a place called Trawarmy. Never heard of it, and I don't think many people really have, but we're going there anyway. And hopefully it's going to be a great time. So, let's hit the road and let's go.
Made it down to sunny Cornwall
and windy,
and here we are at the first stop, just a little site, the Delabole quarry. It's a big old quarry and they're working at the moment by the sounds of it, but it's just a nice little view to kick off the trip. And in the distance there in the middle, looks like we can see Bodmin Moor perhaps.
And that's exactly where we'd be going next, but not before a swift drink to warm the cockles and welcome us to the county.
Made it to the pub.
Yeah, that looks good.
Simple public nudity is not illegal.
But also, right. Why is that specific?
I remember that one.
Right there. Why are we specifically like...
on? You're going to forget that and then you're going to watch it back.
And that is exactly what I had the misfortune of doing.
So we're here at Rough Tor.
We're informed by a local in the pub that it's actually pronounced router.
Which is this little rocky outcrop, I'm guessing it's that big one there. And we're going to try and get up there for the sunset. And beyond it is a place that a lot of the people here love, and it's called Brown Willie. And we might try and go there, but I think we're going to just see how we get on.
It's no joke, it is actually called Brown Willie, but I think we'd seen enough of that for one day, and it was a lot further, so we were just aiming for Routor.
Just going in for the kill.
Oi, don't make loud noises, that frightens them.
That's my aim.
Mate, we are actually going to have to walk past this enemy number two.
Yeah, no problem.
MP, mate.
The animal ahead was indeed a formidable foe, but it wasn't going to stop us.
It's the beast of Bodmin Moor.
It's the final actual boss you actually have to fight.
It's just a bit of a mad sight, isn't it?
Bill Oddie. Bill Oddie could be the final boss up here, couldn't he?
The way he's walking is literally like some like Neanderthal.
So, fearing that every local might be a naturist, we pressed on with our eyes at the ground.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, we are staying on the sea, aren't we?
It's not far.
Yeah.
Hang on, let me even look.
I swear the view out the back was like over the sea.
Yeah, it might.
It's very quiet out here, isn't it?
And alone we were, apart from the odd walker, the odd black sheep, and the fear of a potential beast of Bodmin Moor. It was a stunning landscape and a great way to welcome us to the area. This little rocky outcrop was actually quite high up, and I felt like I was going to lose my balance and break an ankle, so I swiftly got down. And what a great way to spend your last moments than making terrible fetty wop impressions.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah, man.
Right.
Yeah, you don't need to just step straight down.
How's that formed like that? That's bollocks.
It's like a den.
That's a full sculpted tunnel there.
Yeah, that actually is. Look at the blockwork,
yeah,
guys.
But, look at the brickwork.
What if the beast of Bodmin Moor chills out in there?
What if he's like munching a sheep in there?
Oh, he's got his car.
Right. It's a bit of a scramble here.
That was so easy to get up.
Bit of a scramble on our hands, guys. Yeah, this is looking good. And thanks to that little pub trip, we had actually timed it perfectly for the sunset. Truly the best way to begin an adventure. We're working our way down, back to the car.
Yeah, it's a bit slippery by the way.
Is it?
We've just made it to the top of Rough Tor, and we came back down along a little bit more of a challenging route. Well, I mean, that might be a bit of a stretch, but yeah, it was good fun, amazing little sunset, I thought. And we've got a few Cornish cuties and the out on the moor to greet us as we come down. See? And after a meal we headed back to our Airbnb. The view was amazing, but you can't see anything, so let's wait till sunrise. So let's start with a house tour of the banging Airbnb Chris managed to pull out.
Here's the bathroom, the bathy.
I put the mats how they're supposed to be.
Oh yeah. Some serious mat action there.
Stuffing one in the shower.
Get a load of this idiot.
Yeah, boy, giving me a good old rap.
Then we've got this, whatever this is, the Glad Hill Envirofoam. It's copper vented, mate. Right?
That's asbestos in there.
Yeah, could be, to be fair. Nah.
That's a prop.
See that boiler? Look at that. Look at that.
It's all dry, that. Here's the Victorian kitchen.
Yeah, I realised the sides are literally just slabs of slate, aren't they?
Probably from that Delabole quarry or whatever it is.
We actually took down the tiger and carved him up for our breakfast.
We're hoping to do the Beast of Bodmin Moor next, but for now, check this beauty out. And as you can see, I'm repping the Cornish fisherman look today.
This is the lounge, living room. Brexit means Brexit.
Done though.
Done though.
Yes means yes.
No means yes.
Boy, I haven't even seen those views yet.
Oh yeah.
That's crazy. What the hell? Oh my god.
Oh my god, mate.
That sea with that big chunk rock in the middle.
Chunk rock.
Look at that little house.
Yeah, what is the chunk rock? It must have a name, mustn't it?
Big Chungus.
Format B chunk rock.
Big Chungus sends his regards.
Big Chunk Rock sends his regards.
Let's have a little look out here. Oh, it's pretty damn sunny. There's my room.
I'll take a photo.
show us what we've got.
This is what we've got.
Look at the woodwork.
That's a nice woodwork.
Yeah. It's a solid piece, that. Bring your best piece. There you go. How was it in there?
Oh, it was unreal, actually.
Decent. Yeah.
Such a sick bed.
It all felt pretty comfortable, I reckon.
Let's go down into the depths.
Spiral staircase.
This place kept going and going.
Look at this guy getting his Adidas on. Adidas.
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 Are you on bibs today?
Look what we've got here.
All the classics there.
Hopefully we've got some love for the classic Call of Duties amongst us. Here. These games were our childhood. We didn't get a chance to play them. There was plenty more to be seen.
What's it like in here?
My eyes are as brown as the tree trunks.
Look at this.
Little starfish on the wall.
And some other interesting supplies.
Aloe soup. Aloe. My.
Right, let's get out of here.
Let's see what's outside.
This is where I took the panorama.
Now, this place was stuffed with things to do everywhere, but we barely got a chance to use it. The barbecue, the sheds, the hot tub, all this would have been great. We just didn't have that much time here. And it was so cheap. What a gem.
There it is from the other perspective. Yeah, we should go down there and see what's good.
Yeah. That looks alright. Alright, they've cleared like a direct route. What have we got here then?
Think it's back on that one room shed.
Yeah, that is it.
You open the door and Biggie's there. I thought it was going to be in there.
Whoa, it's outside.
Yeah.
What's in there then? Must be a shed or something. Cornwall Springs.
Whilst I did find myself saying Cornwall a few times, we never got to use the hot tub or sadly the shack.
We should come here tonight just for
Definitely.
Fun space.
You see all like the stars and all that?
Yeah.
And all that.
And all that.
Oh, yeah, like, no, like a light. Oh, you can get a fire going.
Cabin porn.
Cabin. Wait, that's actually what it is.
Yeah.
I think I've seen this book in Waterstones. South End.
Of course you have.
No lights, just the fire and the stars.
It actually would be unreal there.
Looks good.
Is that supposed to be a rug?
Maybe that's the pelt of the beast that bogged me.
So we'd had a look around, but now it was time to hit the streets. We started off getting some local produce at the butcher in Camelford. I love a bit of local produce, and we were going to cook this later.
So we're on our way down to Tintagel Castle.
Let's see what we've got. Day two of the Cornwall trip.
So this was approaching Tintagel Castle. It's quite a well-known tourist destination, but it felt wrong to go so close and not see it. So this stunning place features a lot in the legend of King Arthur. Whether or not any of the mysterious myths really happened here, it's hard to say, but it is still a very significant place.
We've got a hazard here on the left. I think we'll have to keep well clear of this. Oh, look at that stone. A loose hazard.
The actual look of the sea and the waves is so nice.
Yeah.
That is like proper turquoise.
Yeah, no, it is. Yeah.
That's that section there. Yeah.
Whoa, this is a bit nuts, isn't it?
Nuts, stop saying nuts.
Nuts food. Do you guys want to pick like each in the middle sort of thing?
Also, that is bad standing up. That made me like nervous.
Brutal, wouldn't it? Like a brutal club.
making look, you nervous.
It's like you've got to take out the
what if that's corner?
Nanny stays.
Now I'm curious about what's ridiculous. It's literally like, how can we be looking at that? Also, I reckon that building is too.
Oh, it's there we are.
Drop here, guys. Is it not? It's not, well,
right,
it's higher, but it's not shit. Yeah, right then.
I mean, it probably looks great, but yeah. I swear that bird looks well big, like.
Yeah, what the hell?
Look at that bit of wall right down there as well.
Yeah. Trust Chris to find his way into a crack. Wait, this is pretty cool.
Yeah, what is this?
Whoa, but that would be like just a mad shot looking up here.
Look at this.
See that?
Look at this.
That's block work. They say it's all natural.
Oh,
give me a break. It's like Chilean miners.
How do they know it's like
sound? Yeah, I'm not sure what happens there.
So it looks like it was a dead end. Here we are at the famous sculpture. Very ghostly, but we were yet to see any ghosts or beasts of Bodmin Moor.
Get mad view of the bridge.
Yeah,
imagine you just like,
on, that is shit,
you carry yeah. too much momentum and you just go
yeah,
straight
I just
over.
I just sort of like stepped down and there was like nothing there.
What is there there?
What is there there? It's nothing there.
Now this bridge was put in only a few years ago to replace a rather rickety looking wooden one. Eventually we made it back to the car.
So that concludes our little trip to Tintagel. No, for fuck's sake.
Oh, you still can't say it.
What is it?
Tintagel.
I've actually made Tintagel. Right. I can't even, yeah, that is it. Right.
Tintagel.
We've had a nice little day. And yeah, now we're gonna have a little wander, see some waterfalls, all of that jazz.
Boys, you actually need to stop with
how tight.
Oh,
that guy's sat around there being fast.
How tight is that?
That is tighter than a nun's ponytail.
Lovely, lovely sunny evening.
We'd set out to a nearby farm to see a waterfall. Why not?
Look at the blockwork. Look at that. Yo.
Obviously, I couldn't go too long without getting some cracking photographs. The sunset just absolutely made it once again. You'll meet this dog in a moment.
Yeah, aren't we making lamb tagabalis tonight?
We actually are. Minted lamb tagabalis.
That sounds sick.
After inventing a new sport, it was time to return to the car.
Look at him, sprightly young fellow there.
Oh.
So we've had a good day, but we've got to get past the final boss.
Like a limping dog.
Yeah, hang on, it's only got three legs.
Wait, has it? I didn't
know. Yeah, I think he has. Look at him. Ah, bless him. Ah, look at him. Look, let's come to him. Hey. He loves that.
He's loving life.
Yeah.
Back at the Airbnb, we decided to carve up the tiger, get some Cornish yarg cheese going, and some mead. We were going to have a nice feast on the lamb from the butchers earlier.
So, it's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life. Now we're going to see what we're cooking.
What have we got here? We've got the hog's pudding going in there. We've got the rodders and the tiger.
Ow.
We've got this, eggs, eggs, and then in there, whoa, we've got the tomato and basil sausages.
Yeah, I'd say visually it's not like
but damn did it taste good. The hog's pudding was actually really nice. It was like black pudding but with spices. Perfect fuel for hitting the road.
So we're walking at a place called something like Luxalian or something. Not really sure how to pronounce it. But we're going to check out an aqueduct and it goes across this valley and the view looks really good up there. So that's going to be the first stop.
Yeah.
Next to this bridge we also found the world's worst guillotine.
Bash your neck.
I suppose that would probably just like break your neck.
Yeah, exactly. Right, it anyway, would still so. Work. Yeah.
But maybe they like screw it down, like it doesn't drop. They have to like slowly screw it.
Oh yeah, that probably is because it's like threaded, isn't it?
Gradually breaking it.
After that cheery discussion, we needed to cheer ourselves up with some beers. So we went to the St. Austell Brewery, which is quite widely known around England.
That's going to be in like every shop.
Yeah.
Life is short.
Then we hit Charlestown, an old fishing village associated with smugglers and shipwrecks.
Now guess what we've bought here? An old brass tankard.
Yeah, you can really see that.
Don't know anything about it. Don't even know if it was a valuable piece.
Or if it was an ornament or what, but it cost £20. I got £2 off. I don't know what, I don't know if you could read, to be fair.
Because he's new a mug when he saw one.
But...
See there? It's a good piece, that. Look at that.
Right, the sun's nice and warm now.
Yeah, that's much better.
Better.
So we spent the afternoon having a little wander around and seeing what we could see.
Look at this guy. Look at this guy.
Look at this dude. Look at this dude.
The sheds.
Now down on this beach here, there's actually some old smugglers' caves and things. So that just adds to the legend of Cornwall.
You were saying, yeah, we reckon, what if this has just come out of the block?
It obviously hasn't.
Like salt deposit.
How could they there's fit so that much salt in the block?
It's literally like fake snow or something, like a
Christmas
leftover from a Christmas.
Yeah.
Santa's shit.
Like,
This is not real ice.
After marvelling at the strange icy substance knocking around in March time, we had to then get a few photographs, this is tradition, and hit the road. We were off to see somewhere a little bit more off the beaten track next. I can't go too long without seeing something abandoned. So we went to the town of Parr, further along the coast from St Austell, and we were going to explore a place where they used to make china clay, which is a huge part of Cornwall's historic industry. But first we had to sneak in. After climbing over a fence in full view of the beach, it felt a little bit too open. It felt slightly uneasy, so we didn't hang around. We tried to head for the buildings as quickly as possible.
What do you think? There's maybe a gap there?
Yeah. To check the coast is clear and go for it. We weren't sure what to expect at this place, and the uneasiness was only added to by this annoying alarm that was going off constantly the whole time we were there, but we were pretty confident that it wasn't us that set it off. Either way, we hoped someone didn't come to tend to it.
Maybe.
So these giant cylindrical structures are called buells. They are essentially big spinning things that dry the clay out. They produce a lot of dust in the process. As big as these buildings were, there wasn't a whole lot of details left in them, but there were still a few good bits worth seeing. Not only did we hear the constant sound of the alarm, but the seagulls were going nuts, as well as some very interesting noises from the geese.
There's some Canada geese up on the roof. A couple of Canada geese.
A fake goose for fake Christmas.
What is it?
Well, it's literally the
It's been going the whole time. Oh shit, that. That's in the distance.
Shit myself.
Oh, let's come over this side. Oh yeah.
After staring the alarm face to face, we headed back to the beach. We'd missed the sunset, but the evening was still pretty stunning.
That's good over there.
After a long day of several stops, we were pretty exhausted, so we went for a curry to finish it off. Here's some of the photos I took in the clay works. The lighting from the sunset really brings some of these out. You can't beat the texture that these industrial places have. We then headed back home and had some more meat and cheese and a couple of olives for good measure. So that was a good end to a brilliant day.
Padstow Harbour.
A new day brought new sights, and we went to Padstow, a little old maritime place where we got some seafood to cook that evening.
Yeah, you say it as if we're going somewhere that we actually know.
I thought that was basically where we go.
I think growing up by the sea has made me really love the charm that these little fishing villages have.
Town centre that he spoke of.
Centre. Find you in the centre.
Chris, honestly, that actually destroyed me for weeks when I first saw that. When we saw it in home.
As usual, we left it late to eat anything, so this was our breakfast. We then took a couple more photographs, and then we were heading back to Bodmin, to the edge of the moors, but actually to Bodmin itself. We were going to visit the old Bodmin Jail. It's one of these classic old intimidating prisons. Really fascinating place. There was so much history to this. We got to see a bit on the tour, which I didn't film a whole lot of, but on the whole it was well worth a look around, and they've converted it into this stunning hotel, which is quite a contrast. Finally, we found it, the skull of a supposed beast of Bodmin Moor. Well, here we've got Chris's GQ shoot, and then the Top Gear new cast, there we go. And then there was the Bodmin Jail Hotel. We really wanted to see in it, so we asked, and the receptionists let us look around for nothing. Amazing. This actually made it twice as valuable visiting. I actually think I found this bit more interesting than some of the newer kind of displays in the museum. Yes, this place has been converted loads, as you can see, but it's still got the original stonework, and it echoes the layout of the original prison. We've just been lucky enough to have a little look inside the hotel. People can stay in the hotel, and it looked mental in there. All the old cells and that have been converted into a very luxury hotel. And we got let in for free because we went and asked them and they let us have a little look. So great little Brucey bonus there. But it was time to get back to the Airbnb for the final night in Cornwall. Here we've got Chef Chris cooking up the seafood, the squid firstly, that we got from Padstow earlier that day. The fisherman prepared it all for us, so he showed us how to do it properly. That was lovely, and we also had a little bit of sea bass, I believe this was, and that was banging. And back on the road again for the final day.
Is this recording?
Yeah.
Pretty sure it's going.
We went back to the farm store to get some local produce to take back home with us, and then we were going to hit the road and check out some sights in Devon.
Just get a bit more in.
Now, I actually went to university in Exeter, so I'm quite familiar with Devon and the surrounding area. So one place I wanted to show the boys was this, the Meldon Reservoir. It's this amazing water reservoir on the edge of Dartmoor. And then we headed to Exeter itself because I wanted to go back and see the sights. So we had a little look at the cathedral. I hadn't been back to the city since about a year after uni, so it was quite bizarre going back, I won't lie. It felt as if nothing had changed, yet also like looking back into my past, even though it had only been 3 years ago. But yeah, these are the roads I used to go down all the time, half the time quite intoxicated, other times going to the shops. And then this place where I went to the gym for the short time that I persevered. And this is the place I lived for 2 years with some amazing people. All kinds of untold antics happened here. And it's still rocking the lovely yellow colour scheme. Beautiful. So I thought, what can we do? So we went to the Royal Albert Museum. It's a great free National History Museum. Tells you about the history of Exeter as well as natural history. So it's a nice varied place that I thought would be good to spend the afternoon.
Do you want to look for me?
So there's like a gallery in this bit, and I think there's like some animals on the top floor.
It's a gallery for free.
Some fools pay good money for that stuff.
I don't know even know what.
Yeah.
But even like the eyes on that statue, I would just randomly merge them together. Just
yeah, no, I see.
What have we got through here?
It's a great one, this. 4:33.
Oh, yeah. That is the exhibit.
Yeah.
Is this like... Yeah, maybe let's do the elephant, because that, like, polishes off the animals.
Yeah.
Well, should we just go right...
We're going to find the elephant.
The elephant. The elephant.
There's Steve. Toned.
So we've finished the Cornwall expedition.
Now I'm going to be honest, the quality of this wasn't very good, so I'm going to do the outro as a voiceover. Thanks so much for watching if you got to this point. I'd be surprised if you could bear it and understand half of what we were talking about. But it's been an amazing trip, we've seen so much and the weather was lovely. Now let's finish on a quick little roadside freestyle.
Hold tight Alex, hold tight Chris, hold tight Lil T, hold tight Elro, hold tight Pharaoh, let's go.